So, yeah, speaking of songs that probably a lot of people don't necessarily know, but maybe, I know there's some of you that know this song. This was a song that was the last song on our second record, and you finish a record, you think you're done on the record, and this was a song we were writing while we were making, and it was literally, I think, the last night in the studio,
yes.
10 years ago, and we had this song, and
Mark was there. We
just said, well, we actually need to just record it because we don't have any time. But really, we shouldn't try to get too much of it. So let's just go in the room, and I'll sit on the piano, and then everybody will just grab a round of mic, and we'll just do the song.
Okay.
And, you know, it's hard to pull out a song in that way. But when you do, you feel kind of justified, like, okay, well, we're real musicians, I think. So at least...
The thing I do remember about this song was our friend Stephen Maroney, who produced Middle of Nowhere with us, as well as with Mark.
And you can't understand what he's saying. Scottish accent said that he's spoken great.
Yeah, nobody would have said it was the saddest song I ever heard.
But that sounded more like a Beatle.
No, it didn't.
He was from Scotland.
I think he said, boys, beer par, beer par, beer par, par.
That was Lucky Charm for that. So anyway, this is a good title for this whole band, but it's called A Song of the City.